the Land Transportation Office's promise of available plastic driver's license cards? Well, that's on hold. Johnson Van Abba tells us why.
The Office of the Solicitor General, or SolGen, is reviewing legal aspects of accepting plastic card donation for the driver's license made by a private group to the Land Transportation Office. Solicitor General Minardo Guevara said they want to ensure the donation complies with existing laws. Guevara adds he also wants to make sure the cards will not affect the integrity of the Philippine driver's license. On Monday, Land Transportation Office Chief Assistant Secretary Vigor Mendoza said the agency will run out of plastic cards for driver's licenses in 2 weeks, despite a possible donation of about 4 million cards from a private group.
Wala pa tayong card, no? Kasi yung, ang pinakahuli dyan, yung donation, we are of 4 million cards. We are still awaiting the final OSG opinion. Para planchado lang tayo, no, on the legal side. Ang totoo dyan, naubusan na po tayo ng card. By the end of January, I think our inventory as of yesterday is only good for 2 weeks.
The LTO chief adds some of their district offices in malls have already run out of plastic cards for driver's licenses. Mendoza also says the agency needs some 12 million cards this year alone. For now, the LTO is now finalizing the online process for driver's license renewal. The LTO has been struggling to keep up with the demand after a Quezon City court issued a temporary restraining order in 2023, preventing the agency from receiving plastic cards for driver's licenses from its supplier due to issues raised by a losing bidder. The lack of plastic cards has sparked criticisms from motorists. For now, applicants have to make do with a paper copy of their driver's license. They, however, hope the issue will be resolved soon.
Sana yung plastic. Pero hindi daw pa ata available. Okay lang naman po basta yung sinabi po na by March, sana magkaroon na.
Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
The Overseas Workers Welfare Administration looking to open more airport waiting areas dedicated to overseas Filipino workers following the launch of the OFW lounge in Naia Terminal 1. Jackie Pascual with the details.
A new airport lounge has been opened at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport Terminal 1 that will cater to overseas Filipino workers. It's called the OFW Lounge, and the facility offers free food and drinks and an exclusive waiting area for departing Filipino workers. The Overseas Workers Welfare Administration says they want OFWs a comfortable experience before leaving the country.
Kailangan nga nilang maranasan, hindi yung para kang second class. For the brief moment that they'll be waiting for their flight, they'll be kings and queens.
OWA, with the help of the House of Representatives and other agencies, help fund the lounge. There is also a charging station, free Wi-Fi, flight display screens, and a view of the runway. The lounge is open 24/7. Ignacio says they plan to put up another OFW lounge in other airports, provided they will be given the support in budget.
Iduduplicate natin to sa lahat ng airports. Terminal 3, we've started construction.
Some passengers were delighted with the new facility.
Kunting social ba? At saka ano, para kasi medyo mahal din kasi mabili dito eh. At bawas ano gastos.
Dati, ano, naghihintay po ng oras na walang upuan, tatambay na lang po kami kung saan-saan. Pero ngayon meron na pong mga upuan, pwede po kami makapag-relax.
Though the lounge is just a few days old, there is already a plan to expand the OFW lounge at Naia 1 with the expected increase of visitors. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Education Department plans to boost its mental health programs after a humanitarian aid organization recorded rising cases of bullying in schools. Joyce Balancho filed this report.
Siyempre bilang magulang, masakit sa kaluban ko noon. Sipo, bakit? Ano ba yung mali sa anak ko?
Filipino mother Conchita was not able to hold back her tears when she recalled the moments her child, a grade 9 student, experienced bullying at a public school. According to her, her son was tormented by children his age because of his height.
Palagi siyang binabatukan o kaya kinakalabit. So, pinabayaan na lang din yan. Hanggang dumating sa punto na binato siya ng upuan.
While the school addressed the incidents, she says the bullying never stopped. The Council for the Welfare of Children, or CWC, says, based on their monitoring, cases of bullying continue to increase in the Philippines.
Patuloy pa rin pong tumataas ang incidence of bullying po natin. Actually, starting 2015, based on the National Baseline Study on Violence Against Children conducted by the Council for the Welfare and UNICEF, 80% po ng Filipino children aged 13 to 24 ang naka-experience ng mga forms of violence. Ano? And whether this is in their homes, school, and community. Kasama po dito yung peer violence.
In the same study, CWC points out that 6 out of 10 Filipino children had admitted being bullied, while 2 out of 5 had been victims also of cyberbullying. Because of these cases, the Department of Education in 2022 launched the Learners TeleSafe Contact Center Helpline. From November 2022 up to January 11, 2024, the helpline received 178 cases of bullying. 83 are physical bullying, 28 are verbal bullying, 27 are cyberbullying, and 40 are other forms. In Quezon City Science High School, a guidance counselor notes that cyberbullying have become more prominent since the pandemic happened.
Dahil nga sa kabisihan nila sa mga academic stuff nila, ng mga outputs na ginagawa nila, yung online platform yung nagiging parang pinagkakaabalahan nila na in any way, kumbaga ano sila doon, anonymous sila doon, di ba? So hindi sila na-identify kung sino sila.
Korea stresses bullying has a significant negative impact to victims.
So, bumababa yung kanilang self-esteem, nawawala na sila ng gana pumasok sa school, ayaw na nilang pumasok sa school, or yung grades nila na dati na okay, mataas naman, aktibo, biglang parang bumaba yung performance nila. And worst case scenario, pag ito ay hindi na-address, it can lead to a serious mental disorder.
But it's not just the victims. He says the supposed bullies should also be given counseling.
Ang karaniwang dahilan nito ay actually may mga batang biktima rin sila ng pang-aabuso. So halimbawa, victim of abuse, halimbawa sa bahay, sa kapitbahay mismo, or sa school mismo. Maaari na ang nangyayari kung hindi ito naagapan o nabigyan ng tulong through counseling, maaring ito ay humantong dun sa punto na, yun nga, sila naman yung gumagawa ng bullying act na yun.
For students who experience bullying, Korea advises them to immediately report to their parents, relatives, or to their trusted teachers so that the incident will be addressed immediately. Parents should also regularly talk to their children so they would know what's happening in school. Meanwhile, the Council for the Welfare of Children continues to coordinate with the Department of Interior and local government to strengthen the local councils for the protection of children. DepEd is also keeping tabs on bullying cases in schools. The agency has also begun drafting a mental health program with the Department of Health.
Pinapalakas natin yung ating mga tinatawag na child protection committees sa mga paaralan. Yung reporting system, we are continuously improving it.
Those who wish to seek assistance in cases of bullying, the CWC and DepEd have hotlines that are ready to receive complaints and reports. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.